What's up, guys? Welcome back. I'm hanging again with my good friend Brian Brushwood. He is the Modern Rogue.
Hey, man, this is Grant Thompson. He's the King of Random.
And today we're playing with some mad science. We've got some drain cleaner, we've got some aluminum foil. What kind of a reaction will they produce if we mix the two together?
Why do we have pink balloons?
Now, this chemical drain cleaner we picked up just came from the local hardware store, and this is not liquid. This is the crystal flakes. And if you open it up, you'll see it's actually dry.
It says contains sodium hydroxide. That's a little terrifying. All right, so before we even began, you shredded a bunch of this aluminum using a paper shredder. What's the point of doing that?
So we did. We got a shredder, we put aluminum foil through it, and that shreds it up into little tiny pieces. The purpose of doing that is to increase the surface area of the aluminum. It's going to make our reaction happen a little bit faster.
Oh, Commander Worf, you look amazing.
So cool. We got our shredded aluminum, we've got our drain cleaner. All we need now is a little bit of water. Oh, we got a little bit of water, so we are ready to rock. Now, when we're dealing with chemical reactions, it's not a bad idea to start a little bit smaller and work our way up. So we're going to start off with this small glass bottle here, and if everything goes to plan, we can move our way up to one of these things. All right, so here's what we want to do. Start off by putting a little bit of your drain cleaner, your sodium hydroxide, into a glass jar. So now we can put in a little bit of our aluminum foil scraps on top. And I don't know, so I'd say about 4 times the volume of aluminum.
What chemical reaction are we hoping is about to happen? Because right now we got what, lye and aluminum.
Right, so lye is sodium hydroxide, NaOH. And the aluminum is basically just aluminum metal, Al. What we're gonna do is mix in some water, and as we do that, the sodium hydroxide is gonna dissolve, and it's gonna react with the aluminum and release hydrogen gas.
All right.
And that gas that's being released is the stuff that we're after.
All right.
And that is why we've got pink balloons.
I'm feeling you. Okay.
So let's start off trying to put a little bit of water in the balloon. Just stretch the mouth of your balloon over your water bottle.
Got it.
Turn it upside down.
Yep.
And put a reasonable amount in there. It's not gonna hurt us to have more rather than less.
Right around there?
That looks perfect. We're gonna fit that over top of the jar now. And once that is secured, you can undo the balloon.
Are you ready?
Yep. And it's gonna let the water in. Boom, there goes the water. Now watch what happens. Wow, that's a lot of water. But you see, as the sodium hydroxide dissolves, it reacts with the aluminum and releases hydrogen gas. So all those little bubbles that you're seeing right now are hydrogen. And here's the cool thing, give it a little shake. And you're gonna see that reaction accelerates dramatically. Oh, this is my favorite part.
Congratulations!
Whoa, dude, check this out.
Holy cow!
Crazy.
Holy cow, it's going crazy!
Whoa, it's like pumping up.
Wow.
So how does that bottle feel now?
It's really hot. It's really, really hot.
That balloon is getting huge. How much pressure can that take?
I don't know. I think we got a little bit more, but I mean, it's about to burst.
Okay, so update, guys. This reaction just took off. After about 2 minutes, it just went crazy.
Ooh, it's hot.
So
it's hot.
Go ahead, pull the balloon off. Just don't spout.
Smell all that hydrogen that we just lost.
Oh, the shame. Ah. That's the smell of failure.
I think I burned my fingertips. That was insanely hot.
Okay, well, let's take a look at this.
Here, feel that.
Oh, yeah, that is really warm. So it took about 2 minutes of small bubbling, and then that reaction just took off in an instant. That balloon blew up really crazy. So we got to do that again.
We'll do the big one. we'll be careful.
Well, let's get a good first reaction with this one.
That can't be good.
That is awesome. I love it. Okay.
So when you stuffed that down, the reaction just went crazy, right?
Yeah, because I put the aluminum back down in there.
There we go.
Okay, and then we want to get that reacting again, so we're going to need to push that back down.
Well, here, I think we can just kind of wash like
that. We can put it right into the balloon?
Look at that.
There we go. Okay, yeah, look how fast that reacts.
Wow.
Dude.
Oh,
that's
it's
amazing.
Overgoing.
Dude, that's filling up fast. What we've got in this balloon, hopefully, is hydrogen gas.
Right.
And we can verify that just by dumping in a little bit of dish soap to a bowl of water. We don't have as much to work with due to our previous
incompetent handling. I hear you.
And if we put the neck of the balloon in there and fill it up and slowly let go, we should start to generate some bubbles.
Whoa! Whoa!
Boom.
Whoa!
So cool, guys. We are confirmed we have hydrogen gas.
Okay, let's take this up to 11.
Let's crank it up. We are super stoked. This idea works. We got hydrogen, so we're gonna supersize it now with a 1 gallon juice container, a lot more lye.
And these balloons I got at a truck stop.
You talking about these things right here?
Okay. Truck stops, they have balloons.
All right, here we go. So I'm gonna start off by just pouring a lot more lye in there. It seems like you really can't have too much.
I would think you could.
Let's go and throw a few handfuls of aluminum. And we've got our truck stop balloon standing by. I have to find a way to hold that on tightly though. I don't know why they roll these balloons up. That's a little bit inconvenient. It's a little bit slippery. So it looked from our last reaction like we got about 2 minutes before it starts going crazy.
Yeah, but you can tell it's already at least starting right now.
You see it bubbling?
Yeah.
Now this is awesome, guys. It's only about 30 seconds in and I already feel the bottom of the glass container starting to warm up. And you can see the water's gone completely cloudy with bubbles. I'm starting to get a slight indication in our balloon that we're collecting some gas.
So I guess really it's just a matter of time, because it really did. It took 2 full minutes before the reaction went into high gear.
Yeah, and then it just went crazy at that point. So here we're definitely collecting some gas. As you can see, our balloon's filling up.
You know what? I bet we fill this one up, and I bet we could tie it off and then get another one going. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
Guys, check this out. It's going crazy. It's actually getting really hot. The glass is getting hot. The balloon is filling up with really hot
energy. Oh my gosh! Oh, that's tell me this is safe.
That is amazing.
Here, let me get another. I'm getting another balloon.
All right, so this reaction is going crazy.
Wow.
We've already filled up one balloon, and we have a little bit. Actually, we still have quite a bit of gas, but it looks like the reaction's settling down.
Well, let's throw this on real good. Quick. Man, that was getting super intense. Look at that!
That is crazy fast. This reaction is exothermic. It releases heat as it reacts with the aluminum, and you can definitely feel that. This glass is so ridiculously warm right now. How does that feel right now, Brian?
Much better now. It feels tolerable. I was afraid that thing was gonna bust open for a second there.
That was amazing.
So here's the next question. If I put a straw into this balloon and slowly let the gas out, if I light the tip, will it keep burning like a torch, or will the whole thing blow up in my face?
Whoa! Whoa!
Hydrogen torch, guys.
It's melting the straw. This
torch.
Is amazing. Look at that.
Whoa. Like a little sodium hydroxide in the morning.
Oh, God.
Dude, that was amazing.
That was incredible.
That was a fun experiment. I'm really glad that we tried that today.
Now, we had another cool idea. What if we took this inside where you could see the flames a little bit better?
Boy, it's warm.
It might be steam.
Whoa.
Whoa. That was super fast.
Whoa, should we light it?
Woo!
Nice.
Whoa! Dude, that's amazing.
Wow! Super cool, guys. So now you know what happens if you mix crystal drain cleaner with aluminum foil and water.
Yeah, you get an awesome torch and you get some nasty slurry. How do you dispose of this stuff?
So what we're gonna do is dump this in a solution of vinegar, because that's gonna help neutralize the base. But remember, guys, you are playing with very caustic chemicals. These are very dangerous. They have very strong warning labels. So if you think about doing any kind of experiments like this, make sure you read the warning labels. They're there for a reason. So guys, if you haven't already, go check out my friend Brian Brushwood. His link's in the description. He's the modern rogue.
Yeah, man, check it out. Me and Jason Murphy are on a quest to become the ultimate warrior, gentleman, and scoundrel. You're gonna dig it.
And as for all of you, thanks so much for joining us for this experiment. We'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. Brian, get off your phone. Let's get back to work.
You're right. Whoa. That was super fast.
Whoa, should we light it?
No, please don't. That was scary.
These industrial strength trucker balloons are amazing.